Hello all, this is mathematics class of class 6th, chapter 10, mensuration, and this is our lecture number 5. In this lecture, first of all, we are going to recapitulate all the formulas for finding the perimeter. First, perimeter of a rectangle is equal to 2 bracket length plus breadth. Second, perimeter of a square equal to 4 multiplied by length of a side. Third, perimeter of an equilateral triangle means a triangle whose all the three sides are equal. Its perimeter is 3 multiplied by side. Fourth, perimeter of a regular pentagon. Regular pentagon has 5 equal sides. So its perimeter is 5 multiplied by length of a side. As all the sides are equal, so we can take length of any side. Fifth, perimeter of a regular hexagon. Regular hexagon has 6 equal sides. So its perimeter is 6 multiplied by length of a side. Sixth, perimeter of a triangle. Perimeter of a triangle means if it is not an equilateral triangle, then its perimeter is side plus side plus side. Seventh, perimeter of an isosceles triangle whose two sides are equal. Its perimeter is equal to sum of two equal sides plus third side. Eighth, side of a square equal to, when perimeter is given to you and you have to find out the side of a square. Side of a square equal to perimeter of a square divided by number of sides. In square we have 4 sides. So it is perimeter of a square divided by 4. Side of a regular pentagon. Side of a regular pentagon is perimeter of a pentagon divided by 5, because pentagon has 5 sides. In the same way, if we have to find out the side of a regular hexagon, then what is the formula for that? Perimeter of a hexagon divided by 6, because hexagon has 6 sides. Again, I am saying, please learn all the formulas very well. Now see today's topic. It is area of plane figure. Today we are going to start area. Okay? Now first of all, what is area? The area of a closed plane figure is the measurement of the region enclosed by its boundary. Means it is that surface which is covered by the with the boundary of that figure. Okay, suppose you keep your pencil box on the table, then how much surface, how much region is covered by that pencil box of the table? That is called the area. Understood? Perimeter is just only the boundary, but area is the surface covered by the figure. Okay, to measure the area of a closed plane figure, we have to compare it with some unit of area. For convenience, the shape we chose for the unit of area is a unit square. Okay, we find out the area in unit square. See, this is one square of 1 meter by 1 meter. Now, if the side of a square is 1 meter, then the unit is called a square meter. Okay, if the side of square is given to us 1 meter and we are finding the area of that square, then its unit is square meter. And if the side of a square is 1 centimeter, then the unit is called a square centimeter. Listen beta, perimeter we will find out in the same units. If the length is given in meter, we find out perimeter also in meter. And if the length is given in centimeter, then perimeter will also be in centimeter. But in area, if the length is given, if the side is given in meter, then the unit of area is square meter. And if the side is given to us in centimeter, then its unit is square centimeter. Now, first of all, I am going to tell you without using formula how we can find out the area. Look at the adjoining closed plane figure. To find the area of the region enclosed by the given figure, we place this figure on a squared paper where every square measures 1 unit by 1 unit. Okay, this I will show you. Just wait. We have to find out the area of this figure. What we will do? We will put this figure on a squared paper. We will draw this same figure, exactly same figure. We will place this figure on a squared paper. And that squared paper measures 1 unit by 1 unit as it is a square. So area is the number of unit square that are covered by the figure. What is the area? Area is the that squares which is covered by that this figure. But there is a small problem. What is that? The unit squares may not fit exactly into the area that we need. It is not necessary na, that squares which we are making completely fit, okay, in this figure. So, however, we can overcome this problem by adopting some rules. Now, see the rules. First, the area of one complete square covered by the region is taken as 1 square unit. Means if 1 square is covered under complete figure. Okay, 1 complete square covered by the region, then it is called a 1 square unit. Then we will take as 1 square unit. If complete square is coming inside the figure whose area you have to find out, if more than half, this is the second rule, if more than half the square is covered by the region, then also we will count it as 1 square unit. Okay, more than half is there. If less than half the square is covered, then we will ignore it. We will not take it if it is less than half. And if the area is exactly half of the square covered by the region, we will take as 1/2 square unit. Okay, if it is exactly half. These rules gives us a fair estimate of the area of the region enclosed by the figure. Again, I am telling you rule. If the 1 complete square covered, then we will take the area as 1 square unit. If more than half is covered, then again we will take as 1 square unit. If less than half is covered, then we will ignore it. And if exactly half is there, we will take as 1/2 square unit. Now see, I have shown you one figure na, that we have to find out the area of this. Now see, same figure now I have drawn on the squared paper. In the adjoining closed irregular figure, see, these are the square boxes, and on this square paper, on these square boxes, I have placed the figure that I have shown you before. This is the same figure. Now you have to find out the area of this figure. Now see how we will find out. First of all, I have told you, you have to count the complete square covered in this. Now see, how many complete squares are covered? See very carefully. Complete squares are only 2. Okay. See, complete squares are those in which I have put these red marks. These are only 2. Now we have to count number of squares which are covered more than half. In the same way, count which are covered more than half. They are 8 in number. Count them. Okay. Now less than half we have to ignore. Now see, how many squares are there which are exactly half? There is no exactly half square covered. Okay. Now what we have to do? Number of complete squares covered are 2. More than half are 8. Okay. So our area is 2 plus 8. That is 10. Square unit, whatever unit is there, square unit. If it is meter, then it is square meter. If it is centimeter, then it is square centimeter. Is this clear? Because complete square, for the complete one square covered, we have to take one unit. Two complete squares are there, so we will take 2 square units. Okay, and for more than half also, for more than half square is covered, we have to count it as 1 square unit. If it is more than half is covered. And how many more than half are covered? 8. 8 squares. So they are also 8 square unit. Estimated area is 2 plus 8, that is 10 square unit. Understood? So this is the way in which we can find out area of irregular figures, okay, or regular figures also without using the formula. Now I am going to tell you how to find out the area using formulas. Area of a rectangle, it is equal to length multiply by breadth. Area of a square, area of a square is equal to side multiply by side, because all the sides are equal. See example now. Find the area of a rectangle whose length and breadth are 12 cm and 4 cm respectively. Length and breadth are given. Okay. See beta, if it is not given, find the area of a rectangle. Then also, if length and breadth both are different, both are given, then means it is a rectangle. Because in square only one side is there. So all the 4 sides are equal. So in rectangle only, measurement of length and breadth are different. So it is, length of the rectangle is equal to 12 cm, breadth of a rectangle equal to 4 cm, area of a rectangle equal to length multiplied by breadth. Below length you will write down the measurement of length only, don't write down breadth. Okay, so length equal to 12 centimeter and breadth is 4 centimeter. Again, I am saying below length you will write down the measurement of length and below breadth you will write down the measurement of breadth only. Don't interchange. Okay, so 12 centimeter multiplied by 4 centimeter is 48 square centimeter. This is the area of the rectangle. And learn the way of doing the questions. First of all, you will write down whatever is given to you in the question. Length of the rectangle, breadth of the rectangle. Then you will write down formula. Area of the rectangle equal to length multiplied by breadth. Okay, again, formula carries marks. So don't skip the formula. You have to write down every time. Formula also carries marks and units also carries marks in the answer. So it is equal to 12 multiplied by 4, 48 square centimeter. See the second example. Find the area of a square plot of side 8 meter. Now this is a square plot. Now and see only one side is given, that is 8 meter. So side of a square plot equal to 8 meter. Area of a square plot is, write down the formula first. Side multiply by side. It is 8 meter multiplied by 8 meter. 8 8s are 64. And what is the unit of area? It is square meter. Square will come and then whatever unit is there, meter. Because meter multiplied by meter is square meter. Okay? So these are the formula of area of a square and area of a rectangle. What we have learned, how to find out the area of irregular figures on a with the help of squared paper, and how we will find out the area of square and rectangle with the help of formulas. Now on the basis of this, you have to do exercise 10.2, question number 1 in book. And exercise 10.3, question number 1, 2 and 3 in notebook. Okay, exercise 10.2, question number 1 in book only. This is how to find out the area with the help of squared paper. So do it in book only. And exercise 10.3, question number 1, 2 and 3 in notebook. Okay, now see homework solution of exercise 10.1, question 13 to 16 given in lecture number 4. Now see question number 13. All of you check your answers. Find the cost of fencing a square park of side 250 meter at the rate of rupees 20 per meter. Find the cost of fencing. You have to find out the cost of fencing. Where we will do the fencing? Fencing we will do on the boundary. And for the boundary, what we have to find out? We have to find out the perimeter. So this is more important that first of all, you must know what we have to find out. Area or perimeter. Okay. Because now we have to do in this fencing, and fencing we always do on the boundary, and for boundary we find out the perimeter. So here length of the fence required is equal to perimeter of a square park. And what is the formula for perimeter of a square park? It is 4 multiplied by side. That is 4 multiplied by 250 meter, because one side of a square is given to us 250 meter. So it is 1000 meter. So this is the length of the fence required to us. Now see, what is the cost of fencing given? cost of fencing is given to us rupees 20 per meter. Per meter means 1 meter. For 1 meter of fencing, our cost is rupees 20. Now we have to do how much meter fencing? 1000 meter. So cost of fencing 1000 meter of square park is 1000 multiply by 20. It is rupees 20,000. Okay. See the next question now. Question number 14. Find the cost of fencing a rectangular park of length 175 meter and breadth 125 meter at the rate of rupees 12 per meter. In this question also, we have to find out the cost of fencing. That means we have to first of all find out the perimeter of the rectangle. Okay, because that only can tell us the cost of fencing. See, perimeter of the park equal to 2 multiply length plus breadth. Okay, so 2 multiply length is given to us 175 meter, breadth is given to us 125 meter. Okay, according to Bodmer's rule, we have to solve bracket first. So 175 plus 125 is 300. So it is 2 multiply by 300 meter, which is equal to 600 meter. So this is the perimeter of the park. Okay, now you have to find out the cost of fencing. Rate is given to us rupees 12 per meter. So cost of fencing 1 meter of park is equal to rupees 12. Cost of fencing 600 meter of the rectangular park, it is 600 multiply by 12, which is equal to 7200. So this is the cost of fencing a rectangular park of length 175 meter and breadth 125 meter. Now see question number 15. Sweetie runs around a square park of side 75 meter. Bulbul runs around a rectangular park with a length 60 meter and breadth 45 meter. Who covers less distance? Okay, who covers less distance? Sweetie runs around a square park. Now how you will come to know that in this question you have to find out the perimeter? Because Sweetie and Bulbul both runs around the park. Around means on the boundary of the park. Okay, so we will find out perimeter of square park and perimeter of a rectangular park. See the solution. Distance covered by Sweetie is equal to perimeter of a square. Why? Because Sweetie runs around a square park. So perimeter of a square is 4 multiply by side. It is 4 multiply by 75 meter, which is equal to 300 meter. Now distance covered by Bulbul is equal to perimeter of a rectangle, because Bulbul runs around a rectangular park. It is 2 multiply length plus breadth. It is 2 multiply length is 60 meter and breadth is 45 meter. So 2 multiply by 105 meter, which is equal to 210 meter. Now see, Sweetie covers 300 meter and Bulbul covers 210 meters. Okay, then who cover less distance? Bulbul cover less distance. Clear? See the next question. Question number 16. What is the perimeter of each of the following figure? What do you infer from the answer? Means what you find out in the answer. See, in all the figures you have to find out the perimeter, and perimeter you can find out because in these figure all the four sides measurement is given. So you can find out with the help of formulas also and by adding all the four sides also. It's your wish. Okay, so quickly I am telling you the perimeter of all the shapes. Shape A, perimeter is 100 centimeter. Shape B, it is rectangular. Okay, so I have used here formula 2 bracket L plus B. Its perimeter is also 100 centimeter. C, that is also a rectangle. I have used formula. So it is, its perimeter is also 100 centimeter. And figure D, it's a triangle. Okay. So side plus side plus side, its perimeter is 30 centimeter plus 40 centimeter plus 30 centimeter, 100 centimeter. So what you infer from these answers? What you special thing you have find out? It can be inferred that all the figures have the same perimeter. Though the shapes are different, though the measurements of length and breadth are different. In first it is a square, second is a rectangle, but measurement is different. Third is also a rectangle, but different measurement of length and breadth. And fourth figure is of triangle. Okay, all the figures are different, but we get the same perimeter. Clear? All of you check your answers now and start doing homework. Thank you.